In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
On a hill far away stood an old rugged cross, the emblem of suffering and shame.
For our goodnight message on this Friday after Ash Wednesday of the 4th of March 2022, broadcasting from the Salesian Pontifical University, Rome, Italy, by your servant Father Eustace Siame, a Salesian of Don Bosco, we listen to the message on the cross entitled The Power of the Cross.
Till my trophies at last I lay down, and I will cling to the old rugged cross and exchange it someday for a
This is the first Friday in the period of Lent, and all the Fridays of Lent we shall be reflecting on the cross in our goodnight messages, because we have the way of the cross every Friday in this period of Lent. The cross is a central feature of the gospel message. Without it, the Christian faith falls apart and would be powerless to save from sin. Many people wear crosses as part of jewelry or get tattoos in the name of fashion, but there is more to the cross. The cross is a graphic reminder of Jesus Christ's sacrificial death for us. It certainly should not be trivialized in any way. The cross represents everything that Jesus did for us, and there is great value in a deeper understanding of the power of the cross. In fact, the story of human history is defined by what happened on the cross. Crucifixion became a form of execution in the 4th century BC under Alexander the Great, when it was used by the Romans for only the worst offenders. This was meant to be a public display of disgrace, where victims were impaled in full view of passers-by. Death was incredibly slow and painful. Sometimes this lasted many days and attracted big crowds. It was the most humiliating and horrific way to die, but Jesus' crucifixion was made far worse by the beatings and scourging inflicted on him in the build-up to the cross itself, not to mention the fact that he was innocent. If you get time to watch The Passion of Christ, a movie that has been watched so many times by many people, it's good to rewatch it, because that is close to the truth. Crucifixion was abolished in 337 AD by Constantine the Great in honor of Christ's death. But there are still reports of crucifixion being practiced today, particularly for those professing Christ in parts of the world violently hostile to the Christian faith. Non-Christians may understandably be puzzled as to why Christians sing songs about the cross, wear crosses, and why crosses are prominently on display in and on churches, even on our graves. It may be assumed that Christians are idolizing something that is simply a cruel torture device. But for the Christians, there is something incredibly special and precious about the meaning of the cross, something that provides focus and clarity. What happened on that cross impacts every one of us. There are several references to the cross outside of the gospel accounts. For example, the Apostle Paul did not want to glory in anything but the cross of our Lord Jesus Christ. Galatians chapter 6 verse 14. May I never boast except in the cross of our Lord Jesus Christ, through which the world has been crucified to me and I to the world. We are all corrupted with sin, with no possibility of working our way free of its hold over us. Hence, we are all born alienated from God. Because of God's perfect justice and love, sin has to be atoned for. Thankfully, because of his overwhelming love for us, God sent his only Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, to pay for our sins. If it was not for the cross and the shedding of the blood of Jesus Christ, we would have had no way of being free from our sin and no possibility of appearing righteous before God. We would be condemned to an eternity outside of God's presence. Jesus had to die to make atonement for us and restore our broken relationship with God and make it possible for us to be reconnected to our Maker. Jesus came into this world to be slain for our sin, and we find this in Hebrews chapter 10, verse 10 to 19. We want to understand the cross in this context. I want you to understand me when you see me making a sign of the cross. When I am starting my meals, I'm not just doing it to show off. No, I am just saying, by this cross, I have been set free. I am just saying, by this cross, I have been healed. I'm just saying, by this cross, I am indeed what I am today, a Christian, a follower of Christ. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit.
As it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
And may Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Good night, as it dreams.
Same to you, Father.
I will cling to the old rugged cross and exchange it someday for a crown. To the old rugged cross I will ever be true. It's shame and reproach glad someday to my home far away, where his glory forever I'll share, and I'll cherish the old rugged cross till my trophies at last I exchange it someday for a crown. I will cling to the old rugged cross and exchange